All right, Sprinter, welcome back. Grab your favorite drink and let's go through 14 ideas for LinkedIn so that we fill your toolbox with lots of possible tactics that you can implement immediately today. So 14 ideas that I've collected because we are heavily using LinkedIn. It's my team that's mainly using it, but I give the strategic direction and I ask them, hey guys, what's working right now? Let me share this with the Sprint University, with everybody who is sprinting right now. So they put their heads together and gave me a list of 14 things that I should share with you. And here are they. First is how to give strategic direction for your marketing team. Because of course you want to limit the time that you are actually putting into LinkedIn, right? So we are heavy users because for B2B sales, LinkedIn is a perfect place. So we are heavy users, but how much time do we actually put in? I put 1 hour per week. It's a Monday morning. I have blocked 1 hour to create content. And then my team reuses that content 8 times in the same week using the refinery system that I will share with you here in the end. So the first thing is to limit yourself. And how do you know what to limit on and what should be the content? Well, you give strategic direction using your flower. You remember the flower that you completed in one of the first weeks of your sprint? You go to the flower now, and each petal is one of the main content pillars, we call them. Main content areas that you're going to write about. So you've done your flower. If not, go back to the flower, create your positioning, and that's your content strategy. Let's say out of the flower comes, you will talk about content ABC because you stand for that. Then you move to the avatar. You did your avatar exercise. Pick one avatar and you are talking to that one avatar whenever you're writing a post. Hey you, I see you, I'm talking to you. Okay, this is how we write things, because imagine writing a love letter to a general audience. It doesn't work. So we always write a post to somebody. So let's say our avatar is a 50-year-old woman in rural Norwegia. That's where, and she has a dog. Then we have her in mind when we write something. Then the company profile. Let's look at the company profile. What can you do in the company profile and in the personal profile? So we would go over the company profile and make sure that you have updated the brand sprint steps. Who is the hero? So the hero is a 50-year-old Norwegian rural woman with a dog. What's the quest? Her mission in life is to counterbalance the evil forces of the automotive industry. What's the obstacle? Nemesis. So what is she fighting against? She's fighting against pollution. Okay. And is there an inner nemesis, outside nemesis? If you don't remember this step, go back to the brand sprint system. Who is the guide? That's you. And then what's the plan? 1, 2, 3, whatever you can describe as a process. Okay, month 1, month 2, month 3. Or, you know, week 1, week 2, week 3. And then what's the call to action? Each post should end with a call to action. And actually, let me add here the so-called hand-raising posts. Because they are the best call to action that you can possibly have. So, next one is the personal profile. You do the same with the personal profile. And now the question that I get all the time is, Simon, should I use more the company profile or the personal profile? And the LinkedIn answer is simple, personal profile. Your personal profile has 70% more impact than your company profile. And so you post from the personal and you tag the company. That's how you use it. You post with your name and you tag your colleagues and you tag the company. Second thing to do are pods. So I'm jumping ahead here. Let's talk also about the pods. Because the LinkedIn pods, this is something that you can do as an amplifier. So, for example, we use pods. We put 50 people together in a pod from our community and say, hey, I'm going to post this on Monday at 6 p.m. Please come and comment in the first half an hour. Some of our clients, they create WhatsApp groups to coordinate that. Other clients, they put it in the calendar of each other to coordinate that. Because in the first half an hour, if you can get more than 12 comments on a post, LinkedIn will push it because LinkedIn will say, oh, this is relevant. And if you don't, then it will just disappear in that huge sea of posts. So if you can coordinate on the time of the post, that's the first thing to do. And you can create internal pods or using the calendar or create external pods like we are creating. We have, I think, 5 pods of 50 people running right now. And by the way, if you're listening to this and you go, oh, I would love to be in a strategy sprint, LinkedIn pod, let me know and we will invite you. Happy to invite you to one of our pods. And you can create your own pods, either calendar or WhatsApp group or directly in LinkedIn. Then focus on the formats LinkedIn is pushing right now. So in each quarter, they have different features that they push right now. And it is right now, April 2023, just for the records. Right now, they're pushing polls and LinkedIn newsletters. So we are heavy users of both. And focus just on those two things and you will have the best results. What are polls? Polls and follow-up. I'm sharing here a poll that I just did 35 minutes ago. And since we are all about growth in market shares and in sales, here, this is something about sales. Hey, how do you do sales? 4 options, and they will just vote. Now, the cool things about the vote is that you can go back here and you can see exactly what people voted. And so if Alex has answered polite email phone follow-up, I can now click here and send her a specific message, a personal message. You know, I'm not sending it right now, but I can send her a personal message. Hey, Alex, you just said A. I am curious about ABCD. And so I can cultivate a normal, human, friendly, polite, natural conversation and intensify, you know, the energy in this relationship. And maybe a couple of weeks later, I can invite her to an event that's also on LinkedIn. I will talk about LinkedIn events. That's the reason why we do events every 14 days, because those conversations, my team will then invite to events. And this is a natural, organic way of starting a conversation, growing a conversation, and then intensifying the relationship. Hey, pass by, we have a workshop of an hour. It's about the topic that you voted about. So it's free. Hey, hang out with us, learn something about sales. And meet others who are also with these topics in mind. That's a poll. And the important thing about the poll is to do this follow-up. You click votes, which is here. It's populating as we speak. You click on votes, and then you click here, this very personal message, and you continue the conversation from here. This is important. Most people do it wrong, and that's why their LinkedIn game is not so working so well, because they don't make it a personal thing. They just blast information. So obviously, those times are over. The only form of communication that works in the year 2023 is personal, surprising, relevant, and it is like you would talk to your friends. You talk about things that they care about. You don't talk in an enterprise kind of speak, but just, hey, me, you, Are you thinking this? I am thinking this. What are you doing? Oh, look, you can do this. Like normal human interactions. Then hand raising posts. Super tool, actually, which is, according to my team, the number one thing that works for us. So let me share with you how we do it. Every week, that's the Monday morning time that I have blocked, my team wants from me a hand raising post. What can that be? It's usually I go to the results of our posts and then I think about a so-called lead magnet. A lead magnet is a little piece of content that people want to download. And so if I know that the topic of long sales cycles is resonating with our audience, I will create a lead magnet on how to shorten sales times. And then the post will be, so the content will be Simon talking 5 to 8 minutes about how I reduce my sales time, okay? That's a video. And then I will post, hello, I just created a video for a client of mine on how they can reduce sales time. Who needs this? Comment hashtag sprint life and I'm sending it over. And so two things happen here. One, the people who need this will ask you for that and you will send it. Second is that you have the chance to get one hashtag forward. So whatever one hashtag is that actually is important for your findability, you can push it there. And you know, in terms of hashtags, you want to have 4 or 5 hashtags that people are generally looking for example, leadership, team performance. Those are the typical ones, sales, marketing. Those are the typical ones that everybody goes for. And then create one that's unique to you. For us, it's sprint life. It doesn't mean anything to most people. So it's not a current one, but it's one that we create. So go for 4 or 5 hashtags that you know are widely used and add one that's just you, that's unique. Okay, this is how you create long-term brand on social media. So that's the hand-raising post. Make one hand-raising post per week, one poll per week, and one newsletter, LinkedIn newsletter per week, and you have a great setup going on. Let's go to the weekly newsletter. What's a weekly newsletter? Let me find it here. Not totally sure where I will find it, but let's go to my own profile and let's see some posts and activities here. And let's see what we find. Yeah, of course, the profile pretty clear here. Double check that you have clear who is it for and what is it for and what's the plan. Then let me see what I can find where there is a current LinkedIn newsletter, because they're pushing it a lot. And so basically we just reuse with the refinery, we just reuse our email newsletter here on LinkedIn. The difference is that LinkedIn is pushing it a lot. So here our follower number is just 19,600, but the newsletter is pushed to, I think, 8,000 people. So it's a very high number for the effort, because we are just reusing content that I wrote on Monday and my team is just reusing it on a Thursday. So it's very low effort, but it's high. Let's see if I see one right now. Ours is called Revenue Systems. There are probably better titles for that. If you can make it more around them, it's better. Not sure how to filter for that right now. So before I waste too much of your time, let me not do it right now. Let's go back to my profile. next thing that I wanted to share with you, but hey, LinkedIn newsletter, do that, okay? Next thing that I wanted to share with you is how you can use the featured section. This is the featured section. So if this is your profile, personal profile, there is a featured section here, and this is quite good to use strategically. So you can line up a couple things here. For example, client testimonials. I think it's a good idea to have client testimonials here, but the first one should actually be directly to book a time with you to talk or to something that's very valuable. So you can use this, you can put a Calendly link behind it and say, hey, talk to me. And so to get immediately people on your calendar, or use this thing here. I think you need creator mode for that. So make sure that you have, you go to your settings on LinkedIn and select creator mode, because with creator mode, you surely can use this thing here, which, as you can see, sends you directly, opens up a new page. And so you can send them directly to your website. I send them directly to the first question of a short questionnaire, because that's the best way for me to have people enter our world. It's a quick questionnaire or an audit or a quiz, something that takes them less than 8 minutes, but you know a ton about them. And if you want them as a client, then you can still call them. This is how we do it, because we want to pick and select the people we talk with. You can use other things and make it much more easy to jump on your calendar if you want just more people on your calendar. Another thing that I have been doing is coherently adding pictures about everything that we do. So, for example, use experience. You can see that I'm an advisor and I have the first client testimonial. Then I run a community and I have a second client testimonial from that community, Pedro, who says, hey, in this community, I entered 2020 and now it's 2022 and my sales went up by so much. And he is telling it, and it's the same, as you can see, the same corporate identity as it's here. So that's a good thing. It shows coherence through the things that you do. So even if you had very different career steps, you can find the common denominator and make it more easy for them to see it. We'll create trust. So I wrote a book and I'm a keynote speaker. Okay, same thing, right? I'm a strategy advisor to a network, same thing. And then of course you can use, like I'm using the things that you teach also here to create authority. And of course, skills is good to have also strategically, and to recommend people and to get recommended frequently. You can use publications, honors, awards. The rest is not so relevant. Remember, the most important things are that once a week you do a weekly newsletter, you do a poll, and a hand-raising post. If you do just these three things, which is one post, one poll, one newsletter, you are going along well. And if you have the same time and you post it at the same time so that the others from your team, from your company, can react at the same time, boom. And come on, some of you have like 200 employees. So if you have 200 people in the same half an hour answering that, you are in beast mode. You are in beast mode. It's so easy. I'm wondering, why doesn't everybody do it? The next thing, yeah, weekly newsletter. Ours is called Revenue Systems. And the reason, so this is the creator mode. And the reason why I'm telling you is that it's pushed so much by LinkedIn. I don't know why, but they are bringing people all the time to that. And so it's a low effort, high results thing for us, might be also for you. Next thing is to have events. I told you, you start with the poll, you continue the conversation, and then you can invite them very lightly. Hey, we have an event about this. Do you wanna pass by? And you learn about this topic that you care about, and you can meet other people who also care about this topic. That's a pretty nice invitation. And of course, it will fill your events. Just make sure we have a 14 days events cadence on LinkedIn, because my team told me that LinkedIn basically makes it impossible for you to have events more than 14 days. It will block the amount of invitations and it will unblock them after 14 days. So that's why we have a 14 days cadence. Otherwise, I would do events every fourth day probably, because it doesn't take much for me, and I'm a experienced facilitator, moderator, so I can basically improvise events that have value. So I would do them all the time if there wasn't a 14 days cadence from LinkedIn. Sales Navigator, if you are not using it, is less than $100 per month and is definitely worth it, especially if you do cold outreach. And so yes to Sales Navigator if you do cold outreach, and you can use outreach software that does the first part for you. We are using Meet Alfred for that. And whenever they say, yes, I'm interested, then you can pick it up manually. And that's only 15 minutes per day of my marketing team for them to answer to the people who show interest. If they say, yes, I'm interested, tell me more, then my team manually gets them a time on my calendar, and then the sales team takes over from the calendar. But the response rate is very low. I think we have 5.3% conversion rate. So of 100 people, only 5 are interested. So expect a low conversion there. Especially in the beginning, you will have 2 to 3% conversion until you have enough A-B tests to have the right messages. And then you get to something between 5 and 6%, and that's where you will have a plateau for a long time. But if it's a software that's doing it, so it's a low effort activity, then it's pretty good to have, 5 people who want something from you with zero effort manually on your side. So it's worth a consideration and it's not expensive. And then when you have done all of this, you go to the university refinery module, because the refinery shows you how you can reuse one piece of content. Remember, Monday morning, we blocked out time to create content. And now during the week, you can reuse that content up to 8 times. This video is getting very long, so let me pause here. It's already 22 minutes. Hope you like it. If you have any questions, tag your sprint coach, tag me. We are here to help. Keep rolling. What if your business would run well even when you are on vacation? Discover how 1,600 business owners have regained their freedom using the Strategy Sprints blueprints. How they enjoy living their dream and watching their business scale. Get the exact checklists they use to go from stressed to fulfilled using the Strategy Sprints method. Order your copy of Strategy Sprints 12 Ways to Accelerate Growth for an Agile Business on Amazon today. And if you love it, leave us a review. For more information, head over to strategysprints.com.